CNBC-TV18 Weekender.
Welcome back. You're watching CNBC-TV18 Weekender, and we're here at the Hidesign factory with Dilip Kapur, the company's founder and president. And we've moved away from the factory floor to the great outdoors. And I think it's kind of apt that we're, you know, interviewing here as you here as well. You're a big fan of the outdoors, aren't you? Just take me through how you spend your weekends here in Pondy, Mr. Kapur.
Well, remember, I live in Oroville, and I live in the green belt of Oroville. So I live right in the middle of the forest. Plenty of wildlife all around. The forest was planted over time. It was a desert, so it's been something that. So yes, we love greenery. We love forests. We love the environment that we have there, and that's what we've rebuilt here. If you can see, all around there's ponds and lakes and waterfalls and lots of greenery.
All the works, of course. And I believe you like spending time with your dog, and I think he takes up a lot of your time over the weekends, doesn't he? Let's get acquainted with him then. What's this guy's name? Tell me all
Pablo.
About
him. He's Pablo.
But, you know, I'm not surprised that you love the outdoors and dogs as much as you do. You've spent a large part of your childhood, of course.
Pablo, come back.
Oh, he's getting excited.
Pablo.
You've spent a large part of your childhood in Pondicherry, of course, where you've explored the outdoors to a great deal. What kind of learnings have you taken from your time in the outdoors to the boardroom?
Well, I think what you learn from nature more than anything else is that, you know, the natural is the greatest beauty. So I love natural beauty. Mm-hmm. And the second thing you learn is that simplicity, not too much artificial stuff, not too much complications, you know. I think those two are the things that that I picked up from growing up in the urban ashram and in Oroville. You know, a love for simplicity and love for nature and anything natural.
And that obviously has taken pride of place in the kind of work you do here, because everything here is eco-friendly. You've maintained that earthiness to the kind of architecture that your factories have taken on, right? Was that inspiration from Pondicherry's earthy feel that you got?
Absolutely. It was all these buildings that you see around here, they were designed by Ray Meeker. And it was made out of bricks that were taken from this earth right here and baked here and then used here. Mm-hmm. So there's a total connection between this earth, these buildings, and the people that work here.
Mm-hmm. All right, so dogs take up most of your time as to the great outdoors, but you are also a bike aficionado, aren't you? Take me through your biking. Tell me all about that hobby.
I mean, within Oroville, we never use a car. We either walk, bicycle, or on my, I have a 1977 Bullet, which I still love. So that's what we use. So I'm not a biker in the sense that I like to go for a long ride, but wherever I have a choice, I would rather not be in a car.
Okay, so bikes all the way then?
Bikes all the
way. So what's your bike collection like? I believe you have a Royal Enfield?
I just have a Royal Enfield. Okay. The other bikes I don't consider mine. They're all there in the house, but they're not mine. Okay. I just have a 1977 Royal Enfield.
You get to ride it around a lot over the weekend in Pondy?
Over the weekend, I also teach in the Oroville school, so whenever I'm within Oroville, it's only the bike. I never use anything else.
But very interestingly, and I hear that you also love travel and F&B to a large extent. You're a wine connoisseur, aren't you? Does that mean that your foray into hospitality, which happened through your course, through your career here in Hidesign, was that perhaps the easiest business decision that you took, foraying into hospitality? You run two hotels here, Le Duple and the Promenade.
Well, I mean, I also love buildings. I mean, I like architecture. I like three-dimensional things. And Duplex, where it all started, is where Hidesign started. Mm-hmm. So that's where it started. It was a beautiful old colonial building. Mm-hmm. And when we moved out here, mm-hmm. You know, we wanted it to represent the best of Pondicherry. Pondicherry didn't have any good hotels then. Mm. So we brought out and took this old building, made it, but it's not heritage in the sense, it has a lot of modernity in it. Mm-hmm. I think that's what's amazing with Pondicherry. There is a lot of heritage, but there's a lot of innovation also.
Sure.
So we brought that there and made a beautiful hotel. It's been, I love that hotel.
Where does your hospitality business go from here, Mr. Kapur?
I don't see us as professional hoteliers. We are not. I think this was, again, a reflection of our belief in a certain lifestyle, belief in Pondicherry's heritage, Pondicherry, the beauty of that, and you know, the same type of lifestyle that we have. So that's what we did there. But I don't see us as hoteliers. I don't see us making a chain of hotels across India. Mm. If we do any more hotels, it'll be straight in Pondicherry. It'll be in, you know, they'll still reflect.
So we can expect to see a few more hotels coming up? Are those in the cards? Are those plans in the cards?
You never know.
I like how you're keeping that uncertainty around. Moving forward then, most recently you launched here at Hidesign, you launched a new Atelier collection.
Right.
I've heard that some very interesting hides have been used in creating these leathers. Just take me through that and where you plan on taking it from here.
Well, I mean, we love good quality stuff, and I think the finest leathers in the world is ostrich, because it has those beautiful bumps and shadings and it's a beautiful leather. So there's South African ostrich leathers that we've used, and the other one is deer. Deer is the strongest farmed deer, all farmed by the way, never used anything wild.
Okay.
So these are from New Zealand, and this leather is so soft, it's like really butter soft, and it's a beautiful leather.
Mm-hmm.
So we wanted to make beautiful bags, you need very beautiful raw materials, and I think we've taken the best there for Atelier collection.
Mm-hmm. All right. And in keeping with the Atelier collection and the new collections as well, the Indian leather industry is poised to hit the $27 billion mark by the year 2020, and that's a huge number for a market like India. Where do you see yourself in the scheme of things, as far as this is concerned?
I think the Indian leather industry is largely a make in India industry. So essentially, we want to make for all the best brands in the world. That's the way it is.
And you are very much making in India, so you are very much part of that plan.
But we're not really, because we don't make for anyone. We only make for Hidesign.
Hmm.
So I think we're one of the rare exceptions there in that sense. We make products for Hidesign itself, then Hidesign, the brand, goes out.
Okay.
And I hope that out of the $27 billion that you're talking about, eventually a larger and larger share of that will be Indian brands that are going global.
Okay.
Talking about the best out of India, which is great craftsmanship, great heritage. I mean, one of the great things we're doing within the next couple of months is we're coming up with something called East India leather, which for several hundred years was considered to be the greatest leather in the world. And it was vegetable tanned. So when chemical tanning came in, it wiped it, pretty much out. There's only a few tanneries left. But we're bringing that out because the past is becoming the future. We suddenly realized that this chemical tanning was horrendous for us.
Mm-hmm.
It was bad for our health, it was bad for the earth. And we're moving more and more, as we get more conscious, we're moving into better leather, which is vegetable tanned leather.
Mm-hmm.
So we're bringing back this leather that used to be in Italy and England, all that was considered the greatest leather.
Mm-hmm.
We're bringing it back, back to life. So those type of things, something that's special out of India, you can't go abroad with something that's already there.
Mm.
You need to bring something that's special for us.
Special for India, special for you, I hope. And on that note, thank you so very much for joining us on CNBC TV 18. With that, it's a wrap on this week's episode of CNBC TV 18 Weekender. From all of us at the team, thank you so much for watching. Do stay tuned to CNBC TV 18.
CNBC TV 18 Weekender.